Welcome, ladles and jelly spoons, to another Friday 5-Minute Facts coming at you live via videotape from the south of England. Today we're in Tintagel, and this week we've had a letter from a young Sophie from Lincolnshire. She's 13 and she says,
"Dear Orbital Broadcast Banker, me and my cat Mr. Whiskers are big fans and we would love it if you would do an episode on our favourite game."
What? She wants us to do an episode on the Chronicles of Narnia, the Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe. What? I mean, I'm on holiday. You can't blame me for being whimsical. Think, lad, you've had one too many bottles of the old cider. Now, from 2005, released across PlayStation 2, PC, Xbox and GameCube, Ladles and Jelly Spoons, the Chronicles of Narnia, the Lion, the Witch and Wardrobe. Yes, little Sophie, I remember this one. Yes, that one with the big wardrobes and all those fairy creatures. And didn't Liam Neeson play God?
Close enough, I guess. It was made by Traveller's Tales for console and Amaze Entertainment for handheld. It hit the shelves just before the movie, and you could play it across the GameCube, PC, Xbox, PlayStation 2, Nintendo DS and Game Boy Advance. I mean, that's quite the lineup. I think you'd agree.
The good old days when you had more buttons than you knew what to do with.
Oh. And that's not all. You know, Disney Mobile also released a role-playing game, a strategy game and a chess game, all with the same name back in 2005 for mobile phones. I mean, talk about Narnia overload.
Now, here's a fun bit for you. Do you know the game features the original movie actors? So you get William Moseley, Skandra Kearns, Anna Popplewell, Georgia Henley, Elizabeth Hawthorne and Jim Broadbent reprising their roles. I mean, it's like having the movie in your living room, but with a controller. Now, in this game, you play as the Pevensey siblings, Peter, Susan, Edmund and Lucy. Each of them has special abilities. Peter's your go-to for breaking down barriers and fighting the baddies. Susan is good at ranged attacks, throwing arrows, tennis balls and the odd snowball.
Yeah, you know, I used to be quite the snowball champion back in the day, until the incident with Mrs. Jenkins' cat. Oh God, poor Snowball. He was never the same after that, you know. My God, just remember his little eyes.
Anyway, moving swiftly on. Next up is Edmund, who's nimble. He can climb trees and he can walk on ice without slipping. He's a real acrobat, that one. And last but not least, you got good old Lucy, who can squeeze through small places and heal.
Oh God, the eyes, as he flew over the greenhouse.
Now, right, throughout the game, you can switch between the siblings and use their unique abilities to solve puzzles and defeat baddies. And right, let's not forget the collectibles. I mean, coins, pink and green gems and hidden shields. Collect them all. It's like Narnia meets Pokemon.
Yeah, see that? Yeah, journey through the Professor's house, the Forest of Narnia, and even escape London during World War II bombings. Each level lets you play as at least two of the children, sometimes all four, making each level a new adventure.
I mean, you'd be the one getting lost in Professor's house, wouldn't you? I know what you like.
Well, Sophie, I do hope this episode was just what you were looking for and that your craving for nostalgia has been quenched. Maybe it's made you dust off that old console and dive back into Narnia. Now, don't forget to like the video, Sophie, share it with your friends and Mr. Whiskers, and of course, subscribe to our channel for more retro shenanigans. Hit that notification bell so you never miss an update. Until next time, cheerio and mind those wardrobes.